Good afternoon, Mr. Fitz.
How you doing, Ben?
Great. I'm not going to introduce ourselves again because we already did.
Did we?
We did.
Okay.
Let's do the next question on your excellent G-pad there.
G-pad.
Love the G-pad.
Don't leave home without it. Okay. So what are the qualities you look for in a prospective employee? Well. Clearly, dashing good looks and a nice lab coat is a good start.
And banjo.
Banjo, yes.
Absolutely. So what I always tell folks, you know, when I'm doing interviews at least, is that, you know, people who do programming, computer science, it's kind of, there's this long sliding scale of extreme practical experience all the way to extreme theoretical experience, right? And that on the one end of the extreme, you might have somebody who just got a PhD in computer science and can write essays on computational complexity, but you ask them to write 5 lines of code on the whiteboard and they can't.
Right.
On the other extreme, you've got, you know, somebody who's maybe been, you know, programming a microprocessor in a cell phone for 20 years and is so incredibly specialized and amazing at writing assembly language, but they've forgotten all the theory they've ever learned, right? And so Google is looking for someone in the middle, right, who's got theory at their fingertips, but also has some practical experience and can write good code. And
right.
That's what our interview process
is about. Well, I mean, we often talk about generalists, right?
Right.
And the example I use is that we don't want somebody to sort of describe what a generalist is. We don't want somebody who knows how to fix the model 400XYZ of the Acme dishwasher.
Right.
Right? And then the model 500XYZ comes out and they're at a complete loss as to
right.
what to do. Right? We want somebody who understands how dishwashers work and can build a dishwasher, fix a dishwasher.
Figure out new models.
Figure out new models as they come out, you know, sort of roll with the right. the dishwashing innovation.
So we're gonna look on your resume for proof that some sign of generalism, right? That you've got practical experience, you've got theoretical experience, and that you're able to learn new things and adapt. And then the theory
right.
then is that, you know, if Google hires you, they're hiring you as a generalist, and the theory is that they could put you on any project and that you would do pretty well,
right?
Right? And that you could move between projects. And people do, in fact, move between projects.
But beyond that, we look for someone who's a good fit for Google in the long haul, okay? Mm-hmm. So skills and experience are important, but you got to be a good fit for the company, for the culture. We work in the internet, right? The internet world is a very disruptive world. A lot of change, a lot of new stuff's constantly coming up. You sort of have to be able to learn new things and roll with the punches, so to speak.
And play well with others, which is not always a given.
Right. So. Well, that's important. But the other thing is that we want to look for something that's going to make you stand out. Right, that's
right.
what we look for in a prospective candidate. Whether it's an interesting hobby or an accomplishment or some leadership thing
right.
you've done.
Because we see a lot of resumes that just, you know, are just full of millions of generic acronyms and they all kind of look the same after a while. So
right.
Figure out some way to distinguish yourself that says, you know, I not only know what I'm doing, but here's something interesting that proves I have a passion for computer science.
Right.
That's another thing I always say.
Or not even just computer science. I mean, it can be anything.
Engineering in general.
Yeah,
right?
Engineering in general.
So, you know, I always tell people, or as I always think to myself when I'm interviewing somebody, you know, if this person were a millionaire and did not have to work at all,
yeah.
would they still be playing around on the computer? Would they still be writing code or doing engineering things for fun? And if so, then that's the kind of person I want to work with.
Right. Is it their passion?
Is it their passion, right? They're not just doing it because they have to, you know, pay the rent. So,
Well, and we come from the open source world, so that's
right.
something that we are particularly looking out for in people. We find that people who write mm-hmm. open source code are often a good fit for Google.
They're passionate.
Because you're not going to spend your spare time writing software if you're not good at it, right?
Or if you're not passionate about it.
If you're not passionate about it. So
right.
those are two qualities that tend to fall in to people that write software in their spare time, I'd say.
Right. So it's not a requirement that you work on open source or something.
Right.
It's just that's an example of something that might stand out on a resume.
Right. So good fit, solid skills and experience, good fit for the long haul especially, and you've typically done something outstanding.
Yeah. Great.
All right.
We'll see you next
time. Come back soon.